Hello there everyone, welcome back to another video about the One Piece card game. Continuing my OP07 content today, I have a tier list for you. Ho-ho, controversial, I know. I cooked on the last one and you're allowed to know I know what I'm talking about. So let's go ahead and get into it. If you're seeing this on Patreon early, thank you very much for your support. I hope this is useful. It will probably not surprise you to learn that I'm planning on making my guide for like two of the best decks up here in like that I think are the best ones in the format, pretty uncontroversially up there as the best ones in the format. But yeah, let's go ahead and get into it. I've already populated I don't really like the game this much tier, just to save ourselves some time, because this is a majority of the leaders, not a majority, but between this and locals tier, that's going to be a majority. In fact, while I waffle, I will probably start plopping some of these into locals tier that I think are really just they're not going to do anything. What I wanted to say was, as we are going and doing this, is that I think that OP07 is a format that is strongly competing with OP06. One of the worst in the game. Post Sakazuki ban, I think this format is pretty terrible, honestly. And that's not me, so like, I don't know that Sakazuki being in the format would actually have really done anything. I think, like, you know, OP06 has Sakazuki in the format, and I think it's absolutely fucking terrible. I think EB format is significantly better, because, like, it really is just a two-deck meta, so you just, you know, learn Sakazuki or play Anil. it's just that easy, right? Whereas, in this situation, it's not quite that simple, unfortunately. It's definitely like there's just so much luck. There's genuinely just so much luck involved here. And I really don't like it. I do not like that there's that much luck involved in this format. It feels pretty terrible, to be honest with you. I'm gonna sort of get into it more, but actually that's not quite that bad. I forgot Uta there. But yeah. That my belly aching and moaning and groaning about the format aside, I think I've now successfully managed to put all of the quote unquote meme tier leaders into where they belong. So now we're really only talking about the actual, like, you know, competitive decks, and we're gonna work our way up. I just want to provide a little more context on my tiering here. So bottom, yeah, I don't really like the game that much. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but like most leaders are totally fucking unplayable. And like, yes, you'll steal a win now and then. This is a best of one game. If you want to have any chance of actually winning a regionals, aside from someone who's never won one, but you know what I mean, like, I've topped enough of them, you need to, one, dedicate a lot of time practicing, and two, play one of the tier one decks. You have to, because otherwise, you know, you can't rely on just stealing a game here or there. And especially once you hit like the top 16, top 8, top 32, whatever it may be, and you're playing best of threes, your fun rogue like deck is not going to do anything. Yeah, I don't really like the game that much. These leaders are fundamentally just like fair or worse than fair, and that's nowhere near good enough. Your leader needs to fundamentally break the game in some way for it to be good, or it needs to be so efficient. Like Sakazuki is an example, right? Sakazuki didn't break the game, but it just made your deck like insanely consistent and made all your removal like that much better. And that in itself like was so far ahead of the rest of the power level of what the game was doing that it made it the best deck in the game, right? And it didn't help that Bandai also kept giving them like totally broken tools. So anyway, X3 drop is like, you could take this deck to a regionals. It is better than locals, but like you shouldn't expect to top. Topping regionals, these decks are, I would say, like not tier two, like slightly better than tier two, not really tier one. They're like pretty good. I can see you topping regionals. I'd be very surprised if you got a serial with one, but it's possible. I don't think you get a playmat though, right? I don't think you make finals. And then win regionals, these are realistically like your top tier decks, like what you got to be playing. So X3 drop. I think a lot of this is going to be meta dependent. So firstly, we can just slap both of these guys up here. All of these guys up here, they can just go into the X3 drop. And the reason is simply they can't beat at least two of the, in my opinion, there are four like really, really strong decks. And then a couple that are like not really, really strong, but are very, very good. And like are very much gatekeeping. And they basically can't beat like at least like two of the really, really good ones, and they probably can't beat some of the gatekeepers too. But they can maybe compete with some of the gatekeepers. So it's not like completely unplayable, but I just wouldn't necessarily recommend it. And you can see, you know, there's just so many, like, I mean, okay, Nami can always go in top regionals tier because, you know, if you go on a hot streak, like, you just do well. Katakuri, I think, is a strictly worse version of Enel, which we'll come to. Rebecca, I'm actually quite torn on. I think you could top a regionals with Rebecca. I think you could. You definitely could with, it's tough, actually. Oh, this one's tough. I'm going to put it in top regionals tier, just because it's funny, just because it's really funny. I definitely think it is, like, in contention. Pluffy, it's, like, fundamentally cheating costs, so, like, it's always good. Perona is definitely top regionals tier. Yamato... top regionals tier. Reiju, I think, has got to go down in an X3 drop now. Any other... Foxy is definitely X3 drop, but it's very funny. This is not like Swords in any way, by the way. Any other ones in X3 drop? Probably this Luffy. It's like okay, but not great. Okay, onto the top regionals tier. And this is the actual tier of like decks that are probably worth bearing in mind. And I am going to order from this point on. So I think like pretty uncontroversially, I can just stack like it like this, like realistically. So far. Okay. Right. We're going to start talking about the good decks here, and I'm going to start talking about some interactions. So, Vegapunk. This deck's a rush deck. It's a really honest, like, yellow rush deck. And it kind of beats a lot of stuff. It's actually kind of, like, a little scary. But not this set. I think it really needs OP08 to just get pushed over the edge. But I definitely think it's a fun meme tier deck. And you should, like, give it a go. I think it's really fun. I think it's honest. It's, like, yellow that doesn't feel awful to play against. And that's always a good thing. Actually, Blue Doffy in 07? No, Blue Doffy gets all the crazy stuff in 08. All the crazy stuff of Blue Doffy's in... No, it's not. It's not. I think you're top regionals of Blue Doffy. I think it's toppable. Barely, but I think it's doable. Uta, I think, is in top regionals tier. Gets another couple of really nice tools. But like, you know, I think you got to go on a pretty hot streak. I think you have some pretty bad matchups to some very, very good decks. I think you can just get absolutely blown out by basically like the main top decks in the format. But, you know, fundamentally you are so favored into all the stuff below that like it kind of has to be here just on a pure power level perspective. Starting to reconsider how many decks I've got in this top regionals tier, but I think it's fair. I think it's fair. Everything that's left is, I think, okay, yeah, is this ordered? I think it's fairly ordered. I think, actually, yeah, this is what it's got to be. All right, best deck in the game, what is it? It's RP Lore. I don't think that's really uncontroversial. I think RP Lore is absolutely insane. I think it just gets, like, another broken tool in Sanji. It didn't need that card. It really didn't. And that really pushes it over the edge. Like, it's a 2k counter. It's a 3-6. What the fuck? That card is just absolutely insane. I don't think anyone should be surprised that I think RP Lore is the best deck in the game. Just like you shouldn't be surprised that I think Enel is second. And I think Enel slaps RP. Like, it's actually kind of brutal. Because RP, you just starve them, right? Like, you just sit there as Enel, you'd be happy. Your curve is absolutely toxic now, right? Like, you have a, the only thing you're missing is a 6 drop. It's coming. Oh, wait, it's coming. But until we get that 6 drop, that's the only thing you're missing. Your curve is so good. Everything is scary. Everything hits like a truck. And, you know, you just sit there, you just stall. You have big, beefy bodies, and they're all very, very scary and very hard to deal with. So, it's just a very, very, very powerful deck. We got the Black Brigade here, and Bob Smoochie and Moria. Both are very, 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 very powerful. Like, good into different matchups. Obviously, both function very, very differently. Lucci is much more similar to Sakazuki. Obviously, worse. But it does have some really bullshit plays. Like, the way this deck gets to abuse Rebecca is unreal. Rebecca pull out the Spandam's dad or whatever. Pull out, like, 4-drop Lucci is crazy. Like, absolutely crazy. And obviously Moria is Moria, right? Like, the deck's very, very good. Doesn't really have Sakazuki anymore to, like, worry about. So that's a matchup that was stressful gone. And fundamentally, it's a 5-life leader into RP lore, which is always good. But yeah, I think also it doesn't... Its NL matchup just got worse, so, you know, and it was already bad in EB. Lucci, I think, has a better matchup into NL, but than Moria, for sure. Just because it is able to, like, do much more removal. The deck is fundamentally built more towards that removal side. You're not having to jam in cards that are, like, just to have your deck function that are not good into it. So, there's that. Okay. Hancock is probably in top regionals tier. I don't really feel comfortable putting it in win regionals. I don't think it would win a regionals, but it's the best deck in top regionals for sure. It's very good. It's very, very good. At just being blue. Like, you just get to use all your removal depending on what the format looks like. This just could be crazy, right? Like, you know, if you're doing stuff like every single turn, like, oh, I remove whatever RP lore has just played and also I draw a card. RP lore is just going to run out of gas. You just starve RP and then you get to keep playing your big things and then you just kill them, right? Counterpoint, why are you not just playing Enel? Very valid counterpoint, by the way. The argument for that is, oh, well, I have a better matchup into black because I get to just bot deck Sabos and so on and blah, blah, blah. Counterpoint, Enel kind of already beats black, but whatever, right? Like, you know, Lucci's slightly harder, but yeah, it is what it is. Rounding out the black trio in the middle and adding some symmetry for extra yellow there. Is BY Luffy. I think BY Luffy is like, it's not, I think it can win. I really don't like the deck. I think, like, as in, it's really fun to play. I actually really like playing the deck. But competitively, I just don't think it's there. I think, like, it's just got too many problems. It, like, I mean, once Enel gets 10 ace, man, like, like, another heal card, like, at that point, it's kind of over, man. Like, it's too hard. And now they get another massive body, and it can attack the turn it comes in, so they just get to, like, turn their cards sideways and just rip cards out of your hand again and again and again. Yeah, I think it's really rough. You also just get absolutely cooked by RP lore, because they can, like, let you get down, like, let you take, like, one or two damage yourself, and then they build up this huge board, and then they just, like, push face at you in, like, loads of massive attacks. Fundamentally, their kid killers are always live, because that's what your deck does. Yeah, it's just kind of tough, and you're obviously, like, not aggroing in the early game, so they're not stressed either. And finally, I think we got the gatekeeper deck here, which is Bonnie. I think, like, Bonnie is the worst win regionals tier deck. Definitely the worst. It loses to half of what's up here in the win regionals tier. But all these decks are really, really good, so fair enough. And it beats pretty much everything in the top regionals tier. I will say, like, there are decks, like, for example, I think Rebecca, Perona, these could win a regionals. Like, they could win a regionals, but it's very much like an unlikely outcome as opposed to, I think, a very likely outcome for the win regionals tier decks. I think if you're going to invest your energy into, like, learning any deck for win regionals, it's either, it's either Enel or RP. I don't really think there's another choice. I think, like, you know, they're both just so fundamentally insane. And, you know, they're not as skilled as Sakazuki. They're just not. I mean, Enel is obviously not. Enel is completely brainless. But, like, Lucci is not as skilled as Sakazuki. RP Law is not as skilled as Sakazuki. There is skill there, certainly. I'm not saying there isn't. But, like, I mean, it's just not the same. You can ask any top player which deck requires more skill. RP just fundamentally, by the nature of what it is, it does bullshit more wins. Without needing to, like, play that long, like, really careful, considered resource management game. But there we go. That's it. That's my tier list. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below. I'm going to put it back up here. Yeah, let me know what you think in the comment section down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, subscribe for lots more One Piece card game content. If you're seeing this on Patreon, thank you so much for your support. I hope to continue to receive your support, and I hope to continue to provide excellent content for you. There we go. That's it. See you guys in the next one. Cheers.